took off way too fast. Now that we've got the ship, refueled, let's see what we're taking with us. Radiation protection falling. It's 100% charged, so I don't know what that thing's saying. Okay, there we go. Leave planet. Alright, before we leave, we're gonna take whatever we can find from the crash. Atlas pass required. Okay. And this thing. Reality seems to fold in on itself. One moment I can see debris. In another, a vast red orb, almost too large and too bright to behold. It knows me inside and out, more than I ever could myself. Could this be the face of creation itself? Or in my hazy, fresh awakened state, am I being manipulated? A name burns itself into my mind, Atlas, and a request, made without words, that I should follow this path, this being, this Atlas set for me. So here's the first real decision that Claire needs to make. Does she... She's drawn to this thing. As a scientist, she's fascinated by it. But she really needs to deal with her crewmates. But I think that her curiosity, her natural curiosity, is going to get the better of her here. She's definitely going to accept. She feels suffused with the warm glow of approval. She was lost, but now she's found. The Atlas acknowledges her allegiance. So she has no idea what that was, why it was in her distress beacon, that's broken, by the way. She's gonna see if there's any more goodies she can salvage over here. Before leaving this planet to try to find the rest of her crew. Nice. Life support power low. Let's see, anything else? Is there just two smoking here? I think so. Oh, there's another one of those stones. Definitely curious now. Oh, here it is. Doesn't seem to be any more crash things here. Back here. No, barrel!
Life support offline.
Okay, we're better. Game's running as well as I could have hoped. So again, I knew people were having trouble. But it's running really smoothly for me. I wonder... I did a little bit of tweaking of my graphics settings, but everything's pretty much on, like, high, so... Let's grab a couple more things before we leave. See here. Okay. I think that's it. Okay, so let's check that everything's stowed away properly before we get into the air. This can go to the ship. This can go to the ship. This can go to the ship. And this... Okay. The ship's full. I'll take the zinc with me. Yeah, okay. Okay. Flight checks. Everything looks good. Claire's never been much of a pilot, so she's just hoping to stay, that she doesn't crash. Okay, that's how you land. Easy enough. This is amazing. This alien planet has ruins. Alright, so... Gonna be confusing. Nice, okay. Alright, let's check this out. Claire sees signs of intelligent life and thinks, well, someone must have seen the crash. They're cool. Once again, one of the great things about this game is that literally no one's ever seen the things that I'm seeing. No one's discovered this place. Here we go. Scared this poor guy. He scared me. Well, not really. I knew there had to be somebody in there. Hello, sir. Huh. He wants a rare silicate. Chrysonite, I don't have anything from you. Claire doesn't know even how to communicate with this entity, this being. She just wants to find out if he knows about the crash, but he seems oblivious. He seems to want something from her, and she doesn't have anything to give him, so... Sorry. Guess that's not helpful. Maybe this is. Claire sees just numbers, but they repeat in a pattern, so 2738, 7382, 3827, 8273. Signal detected. What is that? I mean... A ruin. Okay. Claire's going to leave now. She needs to find somebody who knows what's going on. She sees another ship, so that pilot of that might know what's going on. Took off way too fast. But maybe somebody in here could help her. The only word she understands is Korvax, and he wants stuff from her again. Standing with the Korvax has decreased. Oh well. This seems to be some kind of a blueprint for a better weapon, but that doesn't really help at the moment. And here's a weapon itself. A nice weapon. But it's useless to Claire. That wasn't the door we came in, was it? There's a ship over there. Claire's not gaining much from any of these interactions. These aliens seem really unhelpful. Claire's gonna grab a couple more resources before she goes back into the sky to look for her crew. And there comes a ship. But it looks like the same ships that attacked her. She's thinking she might follow it, actually. Great parking job. Oh, too far up. Hang on. We need these flight controls reversed. Let's see. I think it's in options, right? Flight controls inverted. There we go. Where was I just at? Claire's still getting used to flying this thing. No! Ugh! Wrong button. Wrong button. No! Get back in the ship. We'll get back in the ship quick before the stupid sentinels come. Launch thrusters at zero. The same ruin she was just at. But this looks somewhat promising. This looks somewhat promising. A lot of plutonium. We can get away without aggroing everybody in the world. We're gonna go for it. This is a signal scanner of some kind. Claire recognizes its function. Now, if she can just figure out how to bypass its normal and interface with the visor that she has. Alright, so we're looking for any sort of transmissions that might signal her ship or her crew. Beacon detected. Wow, look at this cave. Claire doesn't have time. Had she arrived here as she was supposed to, she would have all the time in the world to catalog everything in this planet. Not enough fuel. We've got plenty of fuel. Okay. Still can't take off until it's full. Okay. There. Happy? Well, this is a beacon. Maybe there's evidence of her crew having been here. She's kind of disappointed. At least she can activate this beacon, and maybe the rest of her crew will know that she's still alive. Maybe they can find her. Advanced life form detected. Well... Oh gosh, I'm gonna have to get... Might have to reverse these controls again. Where's the landing pad? It's getting better. Twitch ads. Look at that, huh? Well, I don't see any more of those beacons. This looks like a manufacturing facility. Even in here. An automated distress call is all she sees. She doesn't have any idea how long ago it was. Okay, where is this distress call? Crashed ship. That has to be a member of the crew. She's out now, not even gonna check anything else in this place. Go, ship, go! Can't go fast enough. Where's the ship? Ah. It's the cruise, all right. This was one of the more advanced shuttles that they had in there. No sign of any life. Cargo spilled out. Nothing was actually... Not even the distress beacon was activated. Oh, man. Seeing a hologram of one of your friends die is terrible. Player can't even search the ship. It's too distraught. She doesn't even notice the robots This looks like a pod from the ship. I'm gonna reverse these flight controls again. Put them back to normal. It's one of the... This is one of the cargo drops pods that they send, her ship sends down to supply their people on the ground. Can fix your suit or do all kinds of things. Just gonna take the extra upgrade to her suit. Can't hurt, right? No robots around. We're gonna grab some plutonium. She ran as soon as she heard the robot. Another encampment with a scanner. Claire's gotta get better at those landings. That one was almost a disaster. Have to figure out how to bypass this one too. So the other one was pretty easy though. Transmissions. Anything. Observatory. Not exactly that helpful.
Radiation protection stabilizing.
They're everywhere. Claire's not interested in another observatory. She needs to find ships. Crash ships. What's that? Ah, it's an alien ruin. Plants with platinum. What will this world come to?